looking forward to the film.
So excited. One, two, and now three. Come on!
Why are you such a Diary of a Wimpy Kid fan?
I think it's just, it's young, it's funny, but there's a slight amount of adult humour in there, and it's just, it makes me laugh, and it appeals to me. I mean, I was the boy that was always up to mischief, and you watch this and you think, no, it's good, real good.
Do you feel like there are any particularly important messages for young people in these stories? I mean, obviously it deals with a lot of things, everything from bullying to first crushes.
I think there's a lot of messages. I think when you're younger and you're going through the pangs of a first crush, you know, it's devastating, you know, unrequited love. When you love Debbie Southgate and Debbie Southgate doesn't love you, that was my crush. And then you send her a letter and then she doesn't reply or she rips it up in front of you. And, you know, devastating. And you hold on to those things forever.
Debbie, how could you? I guess the obvious question, did you write a diary when you were growing up? Do you ever try and do that as a kid?
I think I tried. My attention span was as it is now. It's like I can get to probably Wednesday. I'd start on a Monday, Wednesday, Thursday max, and I'm done with a diary. So a lot of like my diaries had like, they'll have like January would have like a few entries in, and then it would peter out, so there'd be nothing else for the rest of the year. And around my birthday, which is July, there'd be stuff, entries in there. But yeah, I'm kind of like a highlights kind of guy.
I guess you're too busy to keep a diary now. What have you got on the go at the moment? You're always doing a lot of stuff.
I run a performing arts school with 120 students, so it's absolutely amazing. But you're so busy. You're doing this, you're doing that. I work at Sky News, I work as a presenter. I'm doing some stuff at Sky News. I've written a treatment for a show for ITV. So it's just, you're all over the place.
Can you tell us anything about that for ITV? Is that, I mean, what's that going to be based around?
It's a life makeover show. So we take a person and we change all the facets of their life. You know, so we do their fitness, we do their finances, tell them how to do their finances, we tell them how to do their house, their clothing. So yeah, I was going to tell you the name then, but I can't tell you the name.
Keep that one under your hat. Keep it zipped. I mean, obviously you mentioned that the performing school. I mean, how important do you feel those kind of activities are for giving young people the confidence and skill sets to go forward and tackle being a grown-up?
We have a lot of children that come to the academy because their parents say they're shy and they need bringing out of themselves. So they come in shy, and when they walk in, I'm like, hey, come on in, how you doing? And I go, what's your name? They go, my name's Ben. And there was a guy called Ben. He came to the performing arts school. We couldn't actually say his name. He was so nervous. His mum said his name for him, and he's been there for 2 years. He just played the lead in Bugsy Malone. He was Bugsy, and he was absolutely amazing. He came on stage, he slipped over, he made a joke, ad-libbed a joke, and I'm like, his mum was crying, and all the teachers that are quite hard, and they're a bit like me, were like, yeah, these are students, they're doing really well. It's really emotional to see someone that couldn't actually string a sentence together in front of people playing Bugsy and improvising. Amazing, really amazing stuff.
That's obviously a testament to the extraordinary effect that the arts can have on young people. What was it like when you first discovered performing? I mean, how much did it transform who you were and how you felt about yourself?
I was a rugby player. I played rugby. I was a 100-meter runner and a long jumper. And then all of a sudden, Debbie Southgate, that same girl, back to Debbie Southgate, she started to go to dancing on a Thursday night. So I started to go with her and I discovered performing arts. And then she stopped and I carried on going, and it's just that love of being in the theatre, just everything about it. Like now I'll go to the Opera House to watch the Royal Ballet, and I'll just get, you get absorbed, you get into it, or you go to see Les Mis and you think, oh God, this is amazing, absolutely amazing. I still feel exactly the same way.
Clearly it's a difficult time economically. Do you feel like we're still doing enough to support arts-based programmes, particularly aimed at young people?
I think arts-based programs, you know, it's always the first thing to go. Anything that's pleasurable, it's like with parents, you know, they when they're cutting back on a budget, it's always all the fun activities the first thing to go. But I think because of what we do and where we sit within the whole scheme of things, it's slightly educational and it's good for their children. We're lucky that we haven't seen that much of a drop-off, but I totally understand how you know, everyone's got to cut back. You know, we're in a recession and everyone's going to moan about the fact you're cutting back, but we have to cut back from every single area. Otherwise, we'll end up like Greece, and I don't want that to happen. So, rather, it's boom or bust, you see?
It's been a fantastic boom talking to you today. I think we've forgiven Debbie now because she introduced you to performing arts, so it wasn't all bad. She wasn't so terrible.
I always talk about her, and it's the one thing because, you know, it is that thing that you... I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for her. That one change, that one pivotal time, you know, sliding doors, filmed with Gwyneth Paltrow, I always think about that. If I hadn't met her or known her or she hadn't introduced me to dance, where would I be right now? And being an Essex boy, the Lord only knows.